Good evening and welcome to ATV News. My name is Shalima Lawson. In a digital age, elderly people are struggling to get to grips with the use of Facebook. Jeffrey Moyo finds out more.
Most popular social networks such as Facebook have won the hearts of millions of teenagers and young adults, yet many elderly people are still grappling with modern technologies. Some elderly people interviewed by ATV professed ignorance about Facebook. Director for Help Age Zimbabwe, Priscilla Gabi, said Facebook can only be useful to the aged if they are trained on how to use it.
Given an opportunity to run a program that would expose older persons to new technology, as an organization, we think that program would be most welcome.
She lamented that most of the aged people are not versed with modern technology.
However, as an organization, I can say that it would be very difficult for us to embark on a program that would highlight issues of technology to older persons who are illiterate.
However, some young adults said social networks are not meant for the elderly people.
Yeah, and I don't say Facebook for my age at Kure, I need to eat. Because it was as Muslim as we are as next is my young generation.
Gone are the days of letter writing and telephone booths, and so the elderly have no choice but to adapt to the new technologies. On the other hand, young people said they are delighted by Facebook.
Facebook is good for the young generation because it widens a person's scope of mind. And you learn to appreciate life better, and you are not enclosed in one area. You know what's happening around you.
Technology yakanyaya kuniswe chidiki nokuti mazuva ano inotibetsera kana uchienda kuchikoro unenge uchiresearcha zvinhu zvako pa internet, and especially uchishandisa Facebook unokwanisa kutaura kulinga nema friends ako, saka zvino bridge the physical distance.
However, others are critical of the social network and they say it has brought many problems among its users. Reporting for ATV, I'm Jeffrey Moyo, Harare, Zimbabwe.
A group of women in Nkulumane, a high-density suburb in Bulawayo, have ventured into money-making projects to improve their livelihoods. Chris Bentavura reports.
20 women, including widows from Grengara High Density Suburb in Nkulumane, have embarked on brick molding and horticulture projects to sustain their livelihoods. ATV caught up with the women who were upbeat about their projects.
Project is establishing a mama in the community. Sibone kufaneluti sibelayo since Sapiwa Isborani, so we wanted to make use of Isborani lesi, and at the same time is a like financial
project. Taiyamba isenia green color. Taiyamba nichifuwa chokuti tufula kuti iti tandizi mkati maumwe watu. Munga ngati semazimai amu green color. Tufuna tandizi. Kutandizi wapo uguri isafi. Mwivu tizayamba kurima pandu. Zarima mafrauzi. Tizarima mndiwo parevena vache aribe azimuna.
Tadichifunga kuti tigone kuti tirime maflowers pa ground redu rineiri. Kana tarima maflowers ya teta katarisira kuti tigozo wana kufundisa nerera dzedu zatina zomu zimba zataka sirwa.
The women received assistance from a local councillor in Estira Fomoyo.
Mbamba na songe sa Fomoyo project lei yokucha haistina. So yikuti nje saba lenhlanhla ngoba ukhansilo wasifakela safakela isiborane World Vision, so sasesihlala nje sabona ukuthi into engasisiza njengabantu aba ukuthi lathi sincedisane sincedise sizincede ezindlini zethu ukuthi senze lathi okwezandla njengabomama.
Ukhansela ndingathi ndiyakati 100 nzimba
yekuti tite izvo zvatoda kuita.
Rafumoyo narrated how he was touched by the plight of Glengarra widows.
About the widows who are caring for their families, so we are trying to help them have a source of after growing some flowers here, then maybe from the income of the flowers they will be maybe able to cater for their children, buying some small grocery access books for their children who are going to school.
Reporting for ATV, I'm Chris Quintabra in Glengarra, Zimbabwe.
Marondera residents are unhappy that fake honey is being sold along the Harare-Mutare highway. Jairo Saunyama has the following report.
Unsuspecting residents in Marondera, 60 kilometers from Harare, have fallen prey to roadside vendors who are selling them fake honey. Residents who spoke to ATV claim the vendors sold some honey-like syrup which they fear may cause health risks.
They buy syrup, waste syrup in Gaba, and they put uchipam soro. And when you go home on sugar,
The vendors dismissed the accusations, claiming that their honey is real. Despite the allegations, the vendors continue to record brisk business, especially from motorists and passerbys.
Pazuva tinogona kutengesa mabhotorosi anokwanisa kuita kana 20. Ndokunge makustomer akatiwandei. Kana ari mashoma wo tinongotengesa zvinoenderana nemakustomer kuti anenge akatiwandei zvakaita sei.
The vendors have been in the business for many decades and up to now are still selling honey whether it is genuine or fake. It's only the consumers who wield the power to retain them in business. Reporting for ATV in Marondera, Zimbabwe.
Thank you for joining us. Good night.